Let's bring in Wyoming Representative Republican Liz Cheney, who joins us now on the phone. She's the House GOP conference chair. Congresswoman, thanks for being here. Where are you now?
We're secure, Brad. I don't want to say specifically where we are, but we're secure. We look forward on a bipartisan basis to returning to the chamber to continue and complete our constitutional obligation of counting the electoral votes.
Well, tell me about your experience today. First, you know, a play-by-play, if you would, but then what you think about it.
Well, I mean, look, I think what's important is to just recognize we just had a violent mob assault the U.S. Capitol in an attempt to prevent us from carrying out our constitutional duty. And there's no question that the president formed the mob, the president incited the mob, the president addressed the mob, he lit the flame. This is what America is not. There's just been, it's absolutely intolerable and unacceptable. The mob will not prevail. You know, we all have taken an oath to the Constitution. It's an oath that we carry out. It doesn't bend, to mob rule. It doesn't bend to political threats. It's an oath under God, and we will carry it out. And what happened today can never happen again in the United States, and the president needs to take responsibility for it.
Now, Congresswoman, the president did put out a video urging the protesters to go home and to be peaceful. But as John just mentioned, the tweet he just sent out, these are the things and events that happen when a sacred landslide election victory is so unceremoniously and viciously stripped away from great patriots who have been badly and unfairly treated for so long. Go home with love, in peace. Remember this day forever. Your thoughts about that tweet and the message the president is sending?
Look, the president is abusing the trust of the American people. He's abusing the trust of the people who supported him. We've never in our 245-year history had a president refuse to concede and leave office after the Electoral College had voted. The Electoral College voted on December 14th. And our job here in the Capitol is to count the votes. We will count the votes. But there are serious questions about the president's involvement and responsibility for what happened here tonight, here today at the Capitol. And it cannot be tolerated.
Congressman, do you expect to get back at it tonight as far as action on the House floor?
I do. I think that there is agreement that we must do that, agreement that we will do that, that we won't be deterred in completing this constitutional task, and that agreement is bipartisan. So I look forward to doing that. I think it's really important for us to do that. It's important for us to send a message to the nation and to the world that America is not ruled by mob violence. We have this tremendous history of the peaceful transfer of power, something that we take for granted, but Ronald Reagan said it was miraculous, and I think what we've seen today demonstrates how fragile it is, and the obligation and the responsibility of everybody in a position of authority to step up to make sure that we're abiding by our oath, and to make sure that this insurrection is not allowed to proceed, and that we're not going to be ruled by the violence. I also want to say you've got scores of law enforcement, Capitol Police officers who were injured. It is just absolutely unacceptable. And the president's response so far has been completely intolerable and insufficient.
Congresswoman Liz Cheney, thank you very much.